celebrate the 75th anniversary of the NFL with a diamond collection of hits. As big as Nate Newton.
My claim to fame, I push other big guys out of the way so Emmitt can make a lot of yards.
As powerful as Emmitt Smith. And as strong as Reggie White. It's the 1994-95 season home video lineup.
Reggie White gets it.
Whether you love the Bengals.
Downfield, it's out.
The Bucks.
It's caught. Touchdown, Devin.
The Bills. The Bears. The Broncos. Or the Browns, we have a team video for you. 28 exciting collectible highlights presented as only NFL Films can. How do you pack 75 years of history, action, outrageous characters, legends, stars, and storybook finishes in one video?
And there's a collision. It's caught out of the air. The ball is pulled in by Franco Harris. Harris is going for a touchdown.
Can he throw? He can't.
NFL Films has it all in their special Collector's Diamond Anniversary film.
Recovered in the end zone. The Oakland Raiders.
Rolling out the right. Throwing under pressure.
75 seasons. The officially sanctioned document of everything great about NFL football.
Monday Night Football.
150.
Monday Night Football.
150.
Monday Night Football, baby. The world watching.
The world champion.
For millions, it's the greatest thing to ever happen to Monday nights.
On the season premiere.
Now this special anniversary celebration captures 25 years of great games and magic moments.
Get that Monday night thing going. Ready for some football.
Relive all the memories in the best of 25 years of ABC's Monday Night Football.
Yeah, baby, Monday Night Football is where you gotta be.
Some say the personality makes the man.
Ryan's a know-it-all. Hell, head coaches are supposed to win games, not friends.
I'm Steve Young, quarterback for the San Francisco 49ers, and I'm also an attorney. Personally, I think the two have a lot in common. For instance, you're allowed to make an opening statement, and then the defense can come after you. The punishment usually fits the crime.
Well, basically, I catch the ball and I run. And I catch the ball and I catch the ball and I run. And I
go off the field and definitely outside the lines in the NFL's greatest stars.
Shoot, I'm probably starting to sound like a broken record. That's because I did break records.
Straight from a secret ballot, get the 100 goofiest, zaniest, funniest, klutziest plays in the history of the NFL. They're all here in the deliriously entertaining NFL 100 Greatest Follies.
Until that clock's at 0-0, no matter what, or the field goal's kicked, or we score the touchdown, it's not over. All you see is really white lines and boundaries. Once you get starting in motion and you're in a two-minute drill, things are going so fast that you don't even think about it.
Huddle up. Come on, Bobby, set a huddle, let's go!
There's nothing like a victory snatched from the jaws of defeat. Like a magician, John Elway can make the final minutes of a game last forever.
It's caught.
You can say what you want to. I don't think I want anybody back there except number 7.
Nail-biting drama, action-packed highlights in John Elway's greatest comebacks.
Let's go, we're gonna get some respect today. Respect.
All day long. All day long. Let's just kick that butt all day long.
The third installment in the NFL's hit collection of rock music video brings the hottest new bands, the hottest new songs in an alternative look at the NFL. NFL Rocks on the Edge. Join country music sensation Lori Morgan in a high-steppin', boot-scootin' football hoedown.
This is when the big dogs come out.
There's a good time.
tonight with a win, all right? On three.
This is my night to go crazy just to see how it feels. Gonna dress up, gonna let my hair down like a wildcat on the prowl.
Get there, get there!
This is my night to howl.
Top hits and top stars from the stage and the gridiron in NFL Honky Tonk Country. Wrap up the season with the most anticipated sporting event around the world with the Super Bowl 29 home video coming to you in February of 1995. NFL Team Videos, 75 seasons, the best of 25 years of Monday Night Football, John Elway's greatest comebacks, NFL's 100 greatest follies, NFL's greatest stars, NFL Rocks on the Edge, NFL Honky Tonk Country, and Super Bowl 29. It's the greatest lineup in sports video history, worth its weight in gold, dazzling as diamonds in this very special 75th anniversary year. From NFL Films. The future of the Washington Redskins now lies in the hands of new head coach Norv Turner, who has accepted the challenge of carrying on this team's winning tradition. Turner will expect only the best, but he knows that to succeed, his players have to love the game.
You start by trying to make the whole process, the whole game, enjoyable. I know each day I go out on the practice field, that's my favorite part of the day. You get to be out on the field 2 hours and working on things you enjoy doing, then you're having fun. If our football team approaches this thing in a manner they want to have fun, they want to enjoy themselves, we'll get better, and then it'll show up when we play on Sundays.
One of the Redskins' leaders on game day will be rookie quarterback Heath Shuler, the third pick overall in the 1994 draft. At Tennessee, Shuler passed for 36 touchdowns, threw only 12 interceptions, and ran in for 14 more scores. Rookie quarterbacks face a rough road in the NFL, but Shuler is ready to play.
I think the obvious is to first be a team leader, get your team in a situation to score and win. And everything else will take care of itself. The pressure you have to handle within yourself, and you just got to go out and give it all you possibly can.
He was impressive on film. When we went and saw him in person, worked him out, all the same things were there. He can throw the football. He can run. He's got good size and strength. He's an intelligent person. You say overachiever, and people think, well, he must not be have great ability. He's got great ability, and he gets the most out of his abilities.
The Redskins added quarterback John Freeze in the offseason as well. Freeze started 6 games for the Chargers in 1993 and had 152 pass attempts without an interception. 2 other free agent additions on offense are former Raider Ethan Horton, number 88, a Pro Bowl caliber tight end, and one of the best wideouts in the game, Henry Ellard. The Rams' all-time leader in receptions and receiving yards, Ellard finished 7th in the NFC with 945 yards in 1993. Stepping up from within the Redskins' own ranks will be Desmond Howard. Number 80 has made measured progress in his first 2 years in the league, but more was expected.
He struggled the last 2 years. It hasn't, nothing's come easy for him. He knows it, we know it. He's worked as hard as anyone on our football team over the last 2 to 3 months, and he is going to make a run at being the best player he can be, and I think he's going to have an outstanding season.
Another hard-working veteran with something to prove is Jim Lachey, number 79, who made the Pro Bowl in 1990 and 91, but missed much of the last 2 seasons due to injury. After successful reconstructive surgery, Lachey is anxious to return to his starter's role.
My knee is strong as it's ever been. I'm very excited about going out there and contributing to the team. They want me to be there at left tackle, line up there every week and play all 16 games every play and dominate the guy I play against. That's what they want me to do. That's my job, and that's what I'm going to try to do.
With Lachey back in the lineup to help pave the way, number 40, Reggie Brooks, will be able to rack up even more yards in his second season. Brooks totaled 1,063 rushing yards in 1993, an impressive accomplishment for a rookie. Part of Turner's game plan is a strong ground game.
I like it when a team runs a football. I think people perceive a guy who's been involved with quarterbacks and receivers, someone that always wants to see the ball being thrown up the field and big plays. But the toughness of running the football, stopping the run, is key to any good football team. And hopefully our team will have that.
Off Brooks, up over the left tackle spot, breaks it across the 20 to the 30. He's gone. If anybody can catch him. And a block. He's at the 40, the 30, the 25. Touchdown, Washington Redskins.
Key to the success of the defense in 1994 will be players like Sterling Palmer, number 97, who also put on a strong performance as a rookie. After moving into the starting lineup week 7, Palmer finished third on the team with 4.5 sacks and totaled 62 tackles. In the defensive backfield, cornerback Tom Carter, number 25, didn't look much like a first-year man either, as he tied for second in the NFC with 6 interceptions. Cornerback Darryl Green, number 28, brought his career interception total to 34 and intends to continue to provide veteran leadership for the Redskins.
I think the biggest thing in terms of leadership in football is done on the field. When you're making plays, when you're enthusiastic about what you're doing, when you're enthused about practice, which sometimes can be hard to do, when you believe in the system, when you support the staff, and when you make the thing work, then other players look at that, and that in itself is the best leadership you can ever do.
New additions to the Redskins include former Cardinal Ken Harvey and former Giant Leonard Marshall. Harvey joins the Redskins' number 55, Andre Collins, who totaled 6 sacks and 1 interception last season. With players like these, the 1994 Redskins are ready to continue the tradition of excellence this team has come to represent. Every player, rookie and veteran alike, is already working hard to achieve the level of success Redskin fans and the NFL are accustomed to from Washington. The next chapter for the Redskins is just beginning, but it follows an impressive 62-year history. The Redskins were founded by George Preston Marshall in Boston in 1932, and at first were called the Braves. Renamed the Redskins in 1933, they garnered rave reviews, and in only their 5th season, earned a trip to the 1936 championship game. While the Redskins lost to the Packers, the franchise had proved to be a winner. And in 1937, Marshall moved his club to Washington. Marshall proudly introduced pro football's first marching band, first fight song, and his flair for showmanship extended to the signing of quarterback Sammy Baugh, who led the Redskins back to the championship game in 1937. Slingin' Sammy threw for over 300 yards and 3 touchdowns in a 28-21 win over the Bears. Chicago turned around and overwhelmed Washington 73-0 in the 1940 championship. But 2 years later, the Redskins would have revenge and another world title by beating the Bears 14-6. In 1950, the Redskins started to televise their games, and fans were able to watch their football heroes from their living rooms. Players like quarterback Eddie LeBaron, running back Charlie Choo Choo Justice, and number 41 Billy Wells, whose 88-yard touchdown run in 1954 is still a team record. In 1961, the Redskins moved into DC Stadium. And in their first season in their new home, halfback Dickie James, number 47, explored the new turf in frenzied fashion. His 4 touchdowns in a single game that year is a team record that has been tied, but never broken. Future Hall of Famer Bobby Mitchell, number 49, was another star of the 60s, totaling over 2,800 receiving yards in his first 2 seasons in Washington. In 1965, Sonny Jurgensen threw three touchdown passes and brought Washington back from a 21-0 deficit to beat Dallas in one of the greatest comebacks ever by a Redskins team. 1 year later, Jurgensen led his team to a 72-41 win over the Giants in the highest scoring game in NFL history. Charlie Taylor, number 42, Bobby Mitchell, and Jerry Smith, number 87, set another NFL record in 1967 by finishing first, second, and fourth in receiving, the highest ever finish by three receivers on the same team. Despite possessing playmakers and record breakers, the Redskins of the 60s failed to post a winning season. But 1969 saw the arrival of a master architect. Lured by a new challenge, Vince Lombardi left Green Bay and immediately laid a foundation for success in Washington. With players like Jurgensen, rookie running back Larry Brown, and defender Chris Hamburger, Lombardi's Redskins finished 7-5-2. And while he will be remembered most for the dynasty he built in Green Bay, Redskins fans will never forget the magic he performed in the nation's capital. Following admirably in Lombardi's footsteps was George Allen.
Just remember this, 40 men together can't lose, okay?
With his "The Future Is Now" theory, Allen emphasized experience over youth and put together some of the toughest teams of the 70s. In 1973, Allen's Redskins secured a victory over the Cowboys when Hall of Fame defensive back Ken Houston stopped Walt Garrison at the goal line. In a decade filled with accomplishments, Larry Brown, number 43, became the first Redskins back to rush for 1,000 yards in a single season. Led by quarterback Billy Kilmer, Washington won more games under Allen than in any other previous period in team history. The most significant of these victories was the 1972 NFC Championship game against Dallas. The Cowboys were the reigning Super Bowl champions, but Washington proved to be the better team. In what was becoming one of the most bitter rivalries in professional football, the Redskins trounced the Cowboys 26-3 to earn a trip to Super Bowl VII. Washington faced the undefeated Miami Dolphins in a hard-fought defensive struggle, highlighted by Mike Bass's return of Garo Yepremian's misplayed field goal attempt for the Redskins' only score. Miami kept its perfect record intact with a 14-7 win, but the disheartening loss would by no means overshadow this team's achievements. Allen instilled a high school spirit in a group of grown men, and the Over the Hill Gang recorded seven consecutive winning seasons, a franchise record. As the 70s belonged to George Allen, the 80s will forever be linked to Joe Gibbs. Brought in by Jack Kent Cook, majority owner since 1974, Gibbs launched the Redskins into their greatest era of success and memorable moments.
9 seconds to go. Theismann to hold from the 32, a 42-yard attempt. 20 long enough. It's good! Mark Moseley has broken the National Football League record.
One, ripping his back, looking for Monk on the out pattern. He's got it at the 27, out of bounds at the 23. Art Monk is now number one, the most prolific pass receiver in the National Football League's history.
In 1982, in only his second season, Gibbs' team earned a spot in the NFC Championship game against their most hated foe.
Like he's knocked out. Oh, he is out.
the Cowboys never stood a chance against a Redskins team with their sights set on victory, and the cheers of their fans reverberating throughout RFK.
The door set, hit the ball well, set up a screen, batted in the air, picked off by Darrell Brand. Touchdown, Washington Redskins! I don't believe it!
Washington's 31-17 win was one of the biggest in team history and propelled the Redskins into their second Super Bowl.
I am in a state of ecstasy. Never mind that nonsense about euphoria and so on. It is sheer, unadulterated, uncompromising ecstasy.
We busted our ass. We've worked harder than anybody to get here. Nobody can beat us in a team, and it's worth $70,000 and a big ring.
The Redskins were unstoppable in 1982, and by the time the sun had set, Super Bowl XVII belonged to Washington.
Here comes the diesel. Here comes the diesel. Should come with John Riggins right up the middle.
Shot! Yellow 41! Yellow 41! Hunt!
There's the snap, hand to Riggins. Good hole! He's got the first down, the 40. He's gone! The 35, the 30, the 20. He's gone! He's gone! Touchdown, Washington Redskins!
That, gentlemen, may be the nail in the coffin. No question, it is the nail in the coffin.
With a 27-17 victory, the Redskins had earned the title World Champions. The Redskins followed their Super Bowl year with another NFC championship and continued their winning ways with 10 or more victories in 5 straight seasons. Washington was a boomtown of football talent, and in 1987, the Redskins returned to the NFL's greatest game. On their way to sunny San Diego, however, the Redskins had to overcome a 14-point deficit in their weather.
Hurry, Didier at the 4, touchdown, Washington Redskins!
At halftime, the game was tied. And then, in the third quarter, a punt return gave Washington all the points it would need.
Here's the kick. It's a good one. Green driven back to midfield on the far side. He's got the ball up to the 45, far side 40. A seam to the 35, vaults a man to the 30, breaks it to the near side, 25. Watch out, to the 20, near side, he's gone. Touchdown, Washington Redskins. Darrell Green returns the punt 50 yards.
The 21-17 win put the Redskins right where they wanted to be, at home, for the NFC Championship. In front of a packed house, the Redskins took care of the last roadblock standing in their way.
Back is Williams, looking right, fires it into the end zone, touchdown, Washington Redskins! One down to the Super Bowl.
Defense!
Fourth down and 4. Wilson takes the snap, looking left, throws it into the end zone, batted away, incomplete! Redskins are going to the Super Bowl! The Washington Redskins are the National Football Conference champions. They are going to San Diego.
The Redskins had made it to their third Super Bowl in 6 years and were ready to capture another NFL crown. The Broncos took an early 10-0 lead, but Washington countered with an offensive explosion never before seen in a Super Bowl.
Play action fake, Williams going up top, got Sanders on the fly, midfield, he's gone, unless they can catch him. Touchdown, Washington Redskins!
Doug Williams threw for 340 yards and 4 touchdowns, earning Most Valuable Player honors. As the Redskins seemed to score at will in the second quarter and set no less than 20 new Super Bowl records.
Doug Williams is back, lobs it into the end zone. He's got Didier. Touchdown, Washington Redskins. Holy cow! Holy cow!
Denver never recovered, and a final Redskins touchdown sealed the victory.
Touchdown, Washington Redskins!
By winning 42-10, the Redskins had climbed to the pinnacle of professional football and returned home to a hero's welcome. Over 650,000 fans took part in the salute to their super team. And at a reception at the White House, President Ronald Reagan honored the world champions.
The Redskins didn't simply enter the history book Sunday night. They rewrote them. Fellas, what else is there to say but hail to the Redskins?
The Redskins soared above all others many times under Joe Gibbs, but never as they did in 1991. With overwhelming talent, leadership, and enthusiasm, the 1991 Redskins were the most balanced and powerful team in pro football. They started off with 11 straight victories, allowed only 9 sacks all season, sent 8 players to the Pro Bowl, and won the most games in franchise history. The Redskins began the playoffs against Atlanta, and Washington's capital defense reigned all over the Falcons. The Hogs were right at home in the mud and opened up huge holes for the running game.
Broad and Urbans over to the left side, breaks the tackle at the 10, he's to the 5, diving in, running in, touchdown, Washington Redskins.
The Redskins were on the march to Minneapolis.
The seat cushions all going out on the field, and they're showering the field with them.
Ain't no tomorrow. This is it. This is bigger than the Super Bowl. Because if you lose today, you don't go.
The Lions were no match for Washington, and the Redskins won easily, 41-10. The defense turned the Bills' no-huddle offense into no offense at all. While the NFC's highest-scoring team had no trouble adding up the points.
Back to pass on a quick shot. Throws it in the near flat to Biner at the 5. Dives for the corner. Touchdown, Washington Redskins.
This Redskins team had led from September through the Super Bowl and never strayed off course. With the final score 37-24, Jack Kent Cook, Joe Gibbs, and the players had yet another Vince Lombardi trophy, for they had built another world champion. In the 75-year history of the NFL, the Redskins have emerged as one of the league's elite, thanks to the vision, commitment, and leadership of founder George Preston Marshall, Bobby Bethard, Charlie Casserly, and owner Jack Kent Cook. The coaches and players of the past serve as inspiration to the Redskins of today.
The great tradition of this football team was a big part of the reason I wanted to be here. And the things that players who are still here have accomplished, players that were here in the past have accomplished, and I think it sets a nice tone for young players and feeling a part of that and knowing that they're capable of doing the same things.
With a deep drop this time. Good protection. Screen right to Potts, who slips and falls. And then he gets hit. Drops the ball. Picked up. The 30. The 40. Here goes the man with the run. He's still going. It's Darryl Green. Goes all the way to the Washington end zone. Touchdown, Redskins.
Football remains the same. Football is always an exciting game. Here in Washington, it's always been that way. Even back in way back, it's been that way. And I would say that for the fans, come to the games just like you've always come and expect what you've always seen. That's how we won in the past. That's how we'll win in the future.
The Redskins have won 5 NFL championships, 3 Super Bowls, and sent 18 representatives to the Hall of Fame. And the fighting spirit that enabled this team to be so successful lives on. In 1994, the Redskins intend to prove to their fans and the rest of the league that their winning tradition continues.